On September 22, 2000, in the Skookum Meadows area of the Gifford Pinchot National Forest, a partial body print found in the mud of a bait station set up by the BFRO was discovered. This piece of evidence is famously known as the Skookum Cast. During the investigation, the BFRO set up their bait stations with apples. According to an activity log that can be found on the BFRO's website, quote, "Fish, Knoll, and Randalls leave camp near 9 a.m. to check bait sites. The three trackers discuss the strange imprint. Then suddenly it dawns what animal caused it. Fish and Randalls note the shock in Knoll's face. Each tracker comes closer to have another look, and discussions follow for 2 to 3 minutes. The three observe and note the various parts of the impression and the chunks of chewed apple apparently spewed about over the imprint," end quote. After observing the strange impression, the research team determined that the creature had sat at the edge of the mud, leaned down on its left forearm, and reached out over the mud to grab the fruit with its right hand. A cast was made of the imprint, which measured 3.5 by 5 feet and weighed around 400 pounds. This piece of evidence is talked about extensively in Dr. Jeff Meldrum's book, Sasquatch: Legend Meets Science. In his book, Dr. Meldrum discusses how he and fellow scientists Dr. John Bendernagel, Dr. Grover Krantz, and Dr. Ron Brown examined the cast. Dr. Meldrum continues on to discuss how he noticed what he interpreted to be a heel impression that contained skin-rich detail, which he then shared with fingerprint examiner Jimmy Chilcutt. According to Chilcutt, the skin-rich detail was, quote, "consistent in texture and appearance with other specimens of reported Sasquatch tracks," end quote. Factors like this caused doubt that this impression was made by other known animals such as elk or coyote. What brings even further doubt on this theory is the presence of an impression in the cast caused by the creature's Achilles tendon, a characteristic of a bipedal primate. Even stranger, quote, "the imprint of moderate length hair could be seen streaming down across the tendon, giving way to hairless skin just above the margin of the sole, which in turn gave way to the texture of ridged friction skin," end quote. Still, many critics of the cast have tried to claim that the impression was caused by a kneeling elk, especially the impression of what Dr. Meldrum believed to be the heel imprint. However, Dr. Meldrum refutes this claim when he states, quote, "careful comparisons to elk imprints were made at multiple game ranches and zoological parks. These comparisons, combined with consultation by professional gamekeepers, ruled out elk as a possible candidate for the imprint. The obvious heel imprint and forearm imprint simply cannot be accounted for by the anatomy of an elk. A wrist of a 650-pound bull elk was obtained by Rick Knoll, impressed in soft soil and cast. Not only did it fail to measure up to the dimensions of the Skookum heel imprint, it was clearly distinct in shape and pattern of hair," end quote. One of the things I find most impressive is how Dr. Meldrum concludes the chapter of the book discussing the cast. He talks about how the cast was carefully examined by a primate anatomist from the University of Washington named Dr. Darris Swindler. As a result of examining the anatomical features displayed in the cast, he became convinced of the probable existence of Sasquatch, even going so far as to say, quote, "this was a bipedal animal," and, quote, "in my opinion, the Skookum body cast is that of an upright descendant of Gigantopithecus," end quote. Now, what can we learn from this piece of evidence about Sasquatch and their behavior? Assuming that this was indeed an impression caused by a Bigfoot, for one, we can see that at least in this instance, the Sasquatch was aware that had it simply walked onto the mud, it would have left behind prints, something that this creature chose to avoid, presumably. This is an awareness that is not only found in primates, but also in other known species of animals. I recommend checking out Bob Giblin's video on the Skookum Cast, where he goes into further detail on this topic. Nonetheless, evidence like this sheds light on the intelligence of these creatures. They are aware of the danger of leaving behind evidence of their presence in an area, and will at times work around that danger to maintain their elusiveness. There's so much more I could say about the Skookum Cast, but if you'd like to learn more, I would highly recommend reading Dr. Jeff Meldrum's book, more specifically Chapter 5, which is where he discusses the cast. I will also be leaving a link in the description to the BFRO's website where they discuss how the cast was obtained. I hope you enjoyed this video, and please let me know what other famous pieces of Bigfoot evidence would you like me to examine.